But soon the wine was empty, and Mary said, "My son, we're still thirsty." "My time will come," said he. "You know that they aren't ready," but she insists and gives the word for them to follow him. "Take these jars," said he, "and fill them up with water, and come, my dears, we'll drink and dine. A finer wine you will not find." A year or two went by, and by the sea he taught them, but some had hearts of stone towards him. They said, "Our fathers ate the bread that fell from heaven. What more do you give us than they had?" "My body is that bread, my flesh and blood are for you. So come, my dears, and drink this cup. The time for you will soon be up. Will you dine in the feast that is outside of time, with the bread that gives sight to the blind, and the blood that will flood into your heart when you make up your mind?" Two walked upon the road, their eyes fixed on the gravel, and he came up beside without them knowing. He told them about a man that needed neither spear nor nail, nor death could hold until this morning. They marveled at his words and asked him if he'd join them. "Come, my dears, let's pour the wine. I'll touch your hearts, I'll heal your eyes. Will you dine in the feast that is outside of time, with the bread that gives sight to the blind, and the blood that will flood into your heart when you make up your mind?" "It's better that I go," heart to set your tongues on fire, to raise the dead and put my seal upon your heart. But I'll still be with you until the age has ended. So come, my dears, let's drink and dine and revel in our love divine. In the feast that is outside of time, with the bread that gives sight to the blind, and the blood that will flood into your heart when you make.